Hi. I'm here with our Exodus here in Israel. The Passover is the Passover meal is tomorrow. So as the cross of tension will enter the sun, we are celebrating the Exodus. We are celebrating a breaking free, and it's always this time of year is always the energy that we can use for our personal breakthroughs and breaking free from our limitations. And it's interesting to see how the synchronicity works, how this time of year, the spring, is really like a door that opens, and we can really free ourselves if we are well prepared. We can free ourselves and move to the next level in our journey. So the Passover holiday begins as the cross of tension comes, as the gate of control biting through enters the sun. And we all know that the cross of tension is not very simple energy to bear. People that have cross of tension people in their lives know that. My nodes are part of the cross of tension. I have the provocateur and the fighter. So I meet cross of tension people all the time. They're part of my journey. And I'm carrying the 21st gate, the gate of control, the gate of biting through in a defined ego. So I know this energy. And of course, this energy is not very simple, not to those who carry it, and not to those who are conditioned by it and meet it all the time. And when the sun enters the gate of biting through, then this energy can translate itself into the homogenized way of controlling, but this is not the essence of the gate. This is a tribal gate that is part of the only manifesting tribal channel, the channel of the money line. When we have the gatherer, the 45th gate combines with the 21st gate biting through, and they form the channel of the money line, which is a manifesting channel that is the only outlet for the ego circuit, for the tribe, the only throat outlet for the tribe. And this is very interesting because the tribe is all about our basic primal needs. If it's the need to have a family, to have food, to have sex, and the primal spiritual need to meet God. Yes, so all these needs, the tribe is all about these needs. And the 21st gate is actually the gate that cares for, it's part of the caring circuit also, as the caring stream of the tribe. And it is about caring for the tribe that will actually have and meet all those needs. Of course, the not-self in the homogenized world just controls, but this is about taking control on one's life when this gate is defined. And these people who carry the 21st gate in a defined channel or a defined center, they can't really be controlled, or they can't work for others. It's not easy for them. Let's say it's not easy for them to be under any kind of authority. And when it is in an open center, it depends on the way that this tension or this feeling of the need to take control, how it works with the conditioning, how it works with the design. It's interesting. And of course, for us this week, we are going to feel it for these next six neutrino days. And it's the sun, and we can also see that Mercury sits in the 21st gate too. So we are going to be in this energy of control or the game of control or competition or whatever that connects, that, that belongs to this ego center. And also we're going to talk about it until Mercury leaves the gate. Now it's interesting that we have three gates that are very strong activated in the transits. We see the third gate that we know that Uranus is there. We see that Venus also sits in this gate. So the feeling of the innovative mutation and the difficulties that this mutation brings in the beginnings is even stronger now. And also we see the gate of the joyous aliveness, yes, the fuel to correct, the 58th gate. We also see that Saturn sit there and also Mars arrived. So each of these gates that have two strong activations, we are going to feel it. And this is, this, let's say, rises, this is rising the tension too. This is very tensed. These are gates, strong gates, one format gate, one fuel, very strong fuel, logic fuel gate, and of course the 21st gate, which are all these gates are very strong, and we are going to feel it, feel the tension that these activations bring us. And of course, people that connect directly to this gates is, it is going to be very, very interesting week. Now, the day after, we are going to experience almost all of the stream of taste, the 48th gate, the gate of the well, the gate of depth, the gate of practical solutions, that is the opposite gate of the gate of control, the biting through, will connect to, be activated strongly because the 58th gate connects with the moon, 18th gate, and we have the channel of judgment, a design of insatiability that goes up to the throat, to the 16th, the gate of skills, and forms the stream of taste. So we don't have the 16th activated in the transits, but all these people, all these cross of planning people that surround me lately, and all people that have the activation of the 16th gate in an open throat or with a defined throat, will experience this urge to correct and to perfect and to find the practical solution and to bring it, you know, to show their skills to the world in a logical way. This is a manifesting stream. It's going to be interesting. Those who will feel it, and the others, all the others, will feel strongly the channel of judgment and the practical solutions that might appear as a result of the continuing way of the stream of taste. So this is going to be for like 10 or 11 hours, beginning the 31st, in the beginning of this day, according to the GMT time. And then in the 1st of April, we are going to have two nice things. First of all, we have for a few hours the channel of preservation. After we brought all these mutations to the tribe and we corrected and we perfected, now we are going to give these values to nurture the young ones of the tribe with these innovative practical solutions. We are going to nurture them and give them our new values. So we are going to have this, the moon stays in the 50th gate and Venus moves to the 27th, the gate of caring. So we have the values and the caring form for us a design of preservation, yes, the channel of preservation. But the more interesting thing that is going to happen in the 1st of April is the movement of the nodes. The nodes leave the two gates of the Sphinx, the two direction gates. We had the 13th, the gate of the listener, and we have the 7th gate, the army, I guess, the role of the self, yeah. And we got two gates from the cross of the four ways. The 19th gate is the fuel for the stream of sensitivity. It's a tribal fuel for meeting all our primal needs, starting from the search for God and for a mate and for family and for food and sex and shelter, all these primal needs that the tribe needs. This is the gate that wants and needs. This is the 19th, and the 33rd gate is the harmonic gate of the 13th. It's the other side of the channel of the prodigal, a design of a witness. And this is the voice in the throat that says, I remember. And we will be able to go through our tribal journey and then share about it. It's interesting. The 19th in the sixth line is not an easy line. It's the recluse. It's not an easy line. Interesting to watch what's going to happen to us until it moves to the fifth line. The nodes always begin because they are the only activations that go in the opposite way of all the other planets on the wheel. So nodes always begin in the sixth line, and they go backwards to the first line. So we are going to experience the sixth line first. I'm very happy personally because these two gates connect my design, and I love it, especially when something connects my throat for a period of time. It really makes it easier for me, and I will be sharing even more. So we are going to have a real good Passover week, interesting, intensive, and full of adventures. And what I want to remind everyone who celebrates these breakthroughs of the springtime, of the Passover holiday, I find again and again that this sentence, the acceptance of limitation is the first step of transcendence. This is actually this is the essence of life, and this is the essence of this time of year, and this is the essence of the human design experiment, which I'm now celebrating. Really, in a month or two, I celebrate the end of the first cycle, the end of the first 7 years of my experiment. And for me, this last year, this seventh year, is really about accepting the limitation, and I feel the transcendence, and I feel the breakthrough, and I feel the exodus, everything. I think that really in the last 6 or 7 months, I had major breakthroughs, huge revelations, synchronicities, connections, pieces of the puzzles, last pieces of the puzzles that need to sit and form the whole picture. And this is such a liberation for me. I really, really feel the essence of this transcendence that happened only when you really dive into the limitation, only when you really accept it, when you surrender to it, totally surrender. No fight, no battle, just white flag, I surrender. And things are really happening in an amazing way. So I really send you my love from my liberated mood. And I really encourage you to stay locked in your strategies and very, very loyal to your decision-making process, because this is about accepting this limitation. This is the limitation but it's the only way to break free. So I send you my love and have a great Neutrino week. Bye.